Parametric design is not unfamiliar territory for architects. From ancient pyramids to contemporary institutions, buildings have been designed using a variety of changing forces, including climate, technology, use, culture, and mood. Computers indeed provided valuable tools that has since enabled architects to design and construct innovative buildings with more exacting qualitative and quantitative conditions. In this video, I'm going to present a responsive solar facade panel. Before going to the panel design, I'll quickly introduce software applications that I'm using now. Rhino. Rhino is an herbs modeling application, very good in areas of surface modeling, geometrical analysis, and also offers very precise details for physical fabrication of design components. Hero of this project is Grasshopper. It is an open source plugin for Rhino, which shows scripting actions in a algorithmic floating window. That's what we are viewing it now. With a simple example of high-rise building system, I will explain how Grasshopper works. Let's go to the top view plane. I have three different shapes: a circle, triangle with smooth edges, and a rectangle. Now I am viewing a high-rise building script which I have created earlier. This is a simple script nested with mathematical functions which are represented as buttons in GH window. This script is having three major operations, which are replication, scale, and rotation. This CRV button represents a curve. Let us consider triangle shape in Rhino window as a floor plate boundary, and which is connected to CRV button in GH window. This curve is now replicated in Z axis n number of times, where n is given by a number slider which is set to 0 to 100 numbers, where n represents number of floors, so we can create 0 to 100 floors using number slider. Apart from translating that information, I have given some other functions like rotate and change the scale. The scale is here. Change the scale with the help of these graphs. So now I'll show you how it changes. Given rotation functions using the angle pi, so 180 degrees. At any moment, we can freeze the design and generate an alternative based on aesthetics and programmed decisions. This button will build planar surfaces from replicated curves. When the button is selected in GH window, the related geometry turns green in Rhino window. By disabling this button, we can hide geometry in Rhino. and also generate areas from each floor, which is indeed a valuable information. We can create the thickness of the floors by using extrude button, and we can change thickness of each floor by lofting all the planar curves. We can generate a surface geometry that can be used as a grid for a panel that we are going to design. For the panel design, I'm using a SunPath script which I got from Grasshopper open source resources. This algorithm has a control panel where we can change the position of the sun using year, month, day, hours, time zone, longitude and latitude. We can also change the scale of SunPath diagram using scale factor. And north angle based on the project position. I have square surface in Rhino and take that information to GH window by setting on surface button. By using explode button, I got four vertices from the mesh. By joining these points, I have created four lines. With the help of these lines and distance between the points, I have created some offset lines using angle between the sun and surface normal of the polygon mesh. Use trigonometric functions to get sliding and rotation action at the same time for the offsetted lines. As we see, the panel is divided into two parts. The top portion slides upwards and bottom portion slides downwards, for which I have given negative values for the bottom panel. Let's apply this cell to our building system. To make it simple, let's make our building to a 9-story structure. Enable floors, surface and subsurface. We can tweak the shape of the building anytime by using scaled graphs. So now, instead of exploding square surface, explode subsurface from the tower algorithm. Now the cell got applied to all the building. Surprisingly, we got a dynamic facade where the panel is used as a shading device at some places and gradually changes to a closed panel. Finally, we can export these amazing geometries to make a presentation rendering. I find Grasshopper very handy as a parametric design tool for architectural design explorations and analysis. If you are interested in parametric design for architectural projects, competitions and academic research, feel free to contact me at info@raviadusumilli.com. Thank you for watching this video.